My goat's leg was broken, and I'm gonna show you the steps I took to mend that broken leg. And then I gotta share some news with you guys. Stay tuned. Hey, welcome back to Pine Meadows Hobby Farm. I'm your host, Jerry Hansen, like I said in the bumper. Gotta show you guys how to mend a broken goat leg. Yeah, a couple years ago, tree fell on my fence line, crushed the fence, allowed the coyotes to get in. The coyotes took advantage and scared the snot out of the goat, so the one goat jumped over this barrier into this area of the barn. Came in the next morning and found that the goat was in the wrong side, didn't see the broken leg at first, so I got her back over in the appropriate place of where she should be. Then I saw her leg just kind of dangling there. It's like, oh, crap. So I had to tend to that. Then I discovered later my turkeys had disappeared, so predators. Man, it's an never-ending battle. So let me show you steps I took to mend this poor goat's leg. So, this is where the drama takes place, is right in here. I did, at first, think about calling the butcher. Yeah, didn't want to do it. So, I thought about it, and was like, wait a minute. I know first aid. I work in the hospital. I know how to do these things. Never set a broken leg before. So, I went online, and I looked to see what I needed to do. And the goat's leg was broken right here between her joint and her hoof. And so I thought, okay, that's a good place for the break to be. And so I went down to our local feed store and I got the appropriate stuff. I picked up some tape, medical tape, and some gauze. For wrapping to cushion the leg, and then I bought also purchased some hot pink ace bandage for the poor girl. Yeah, it matched her collar. Anyway, I also got some paint sticks. The lady who I bought the goat from, she actually works at the feed store, and I talked to her about it, and she suggested I splint them with some paint sticks. So she gave me some paint sticks. And then also I bought some foam pipe cover that it protects pipes from freezing. Cut it down to the length. I wrapped the leg, stabilized the leg, got it nice and stable and set. And then I put the other material on it to help stabilize it. And she was a trooper through the whole thing. I did have to tie her around her head to the stall so she wouldn't jump around. So it went pretty well. It did. Her leg set. She was able to be on it. You know, I forgot how many weeks I had. I took it off. Christmas is when I took it off. The whole fiasco happened Halloween night is when she broke her leg. Then I just took the splint off Christmas. I figured that was long enough. But also when I set her leg and mended it, I also got some penicillin for goats and took about 2 milliliters with the hypodermic needle that was available for sale at the same feed store and did a subcutaneous injection, not intramuscular, but a subcutaneous, just under the skin. And so she got her dosages of penicillin, and she's doing great. Got that thing off, and then she followed up later. We let her get pregnant the following year, and she had twins. Yeah, she jumped over this barrier right here down into this area of the barn. Don't know how she did it, but those coyotes sure scared the wizards out of her. Hi, sweetie. I want to show you guys something. Here's the announcement. Look at that. Nice and healthy. Eating good. And she is preggers. Yeah, she'll probably give me twins. Sometimes they give me triplets. Her sister's the same way. Look at their bellies. They're big. I bred them in, October or November. I like to control the breeding program because I don't want kids out in the winter. We've got another 14 days to go and we get into spring and daylight savings time. And it's middle of March is about a good time to start having kids in our experience in our region because it can get cold up here. We're in the high elevations. And then my friend, she also has her kids due around the same time. She's the one that actually I bought the boys from. So, yep, pregnant babies. Yeah. They're having their breakfast. So, that's about it on mending a broken leg on a animal. Just make sure you get their penicillin and... keep an eye on them, watch them. But setting the leg was really no big deal. It's not, you could do it. Anybody could do it. You just got to do it. Well, that's all I have to say on this subject, is mending a broken leg. Stay tuned to more videos. You could do that by subscribing, then clicking that bell icon. That'll alert you to new videos as I upload them. Also, please give us a thumbs up. If you like the show, give us a thumbs up. And also share my videos on your social media platforms. It informs other people that may have like problems. Very helpful. Remember, be safe, always be kind. We'll see you guys in the next adventure. Bye-bye now.